Hello everyone, my name is Shai Levine from Checkpoint Solution Center. Thank you everyone for joining me this session. Today I'm going to show you a live demonstration of using EternalBlue exploit that was developed by the NSA and stolen in 2017. The attack I'm going to run would be against Windows Server 2016 that is protected by NSX distributed firewall. It's a Vmware NSX distributed firewall. You will see that the NSX firewall alone does not protect your servers. Next, I will show you how redirecting the traffic to Checkpoint CloudGaurd service will prevent such sophisticated attack. I have already spun up an environment from DemoPoint. You will be able to do the same later on by yourself. In each environment, you will find a resource tab that has a cookbook. The cookbook has a step-by-step instruction, so you will be able to follow them and perform this demo by yourself. The cookbook contains four use cases. This session is focused on the last one, use case number four. I'm going to operate this demo from the vCenter that is installed on the Windows Server. You can connect to it over the browser or by using a native RDP. I prefer the native RDP option. Let's open the vSphere web client. First, I want to show you that the server 2016 IP 10.0.0.199 that resides on the E6 host is only protected by NSX firewall. Let's take a look on the NSX configuration. First, I want to check what traffic is currently redirected to the Checkpoint CloudGaurd service. There are two rules in the network interception policy. One from any to the policy security group, and the second one is out of it. Both are redirected to the CloudGaurd service. Now, let's check on which group that policy was applied. We can see that this policy was applied to all VMs group. Let's check what object this group contained. We can see that all VMs group does not contain the server 2016. Now we know the traffic that goes from this VM is not redirected through the CloudGaurd service. Now let's see if there are NSX firewall rules that protect the 2016 server. We can see two rules, one that permit from any source to the 2016 VM only RDP, ICMP, and Microsoft DS, which is TCP 455, and the second rule drop all traffic. Let's open RDP to the 2016 server from the vCenter. I will log in with the user test. As you can see, user test is not a privileged user. Now we'll try to copy a text file from the desktop to the C drive. As you can see, this action is not permitted since I'm not a privileged user. I need to provide the administrator password in order to perform this task. Let's try to use the EternalBlue exploit from the Kali server that is on the same VLAN broadcast domain as the 2016 server. I will open an SSH session to the Kali Linux VM. I want to check first that the script used the non-privileged test user. Now we are ready to run the exploit. From the message that we get, we see that we succeeded in our task. The text file was created on the 2016 C drive. Let's check that it is there. Now let's delete the file by providing the administrator password. Now I will redirect the traffic to the 2016 server to the CloudGaurd service by adding the 2016 VM to the NSX All VMs group. Now all traffic to the 2016 server is redirected to the CloudGaurd service. On the Checkpoint access rule base, I created a rule that permits traffic from the Kali Linux server to the 2016 server on Microsoft DS services. Now let's find the EternalBlue signature on the IPS database. We can see that the action for the signature is blocked. Let's install the threat prevention policy and run the exploit again. This time the attack was blocked, and we can see an IPS log that indicates that the Kali was trying to attack the 2016 server by using the EternalBlue exploit, and the attack was prevented. In order to make sure the attack was prevented, let's switch to the 2016 desktop. As you can see, no files were created this time on the C drive. So remember, if you are using just the NSX firewall alone, you are not protected. Thank you for joining me, and goodbye.